This is how you can mod your first PlayStation for only $5. Hi everyone, how it's going? My name is Louriki and welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a long time since I posted my last video, but trust me, it's for good reasons. One of them is improving my skills so I could bring you this project. When you think about modding a PlayStation, you probably think about the XStation or the PSIO. These modchips have been around for a long time, but not anymore. Today, I'm so excited to show you how you can mod the original PlayStation using just the Raspberry Pi Pico. Big thanks to the community of Paulo Code and amazing work of a Mexican guy. You should definitely check out his channel. I'm gonna leave all links in the description down below. Okay, this mod works only with the PU8 and PU18 motherboard, which you will find in 1000 and 5500 PlayStation model and rarely the 7000 model. And the cost, Louriki? Only $5, my friend, yeah. And you can play around 90% of the game library and they all run perfectly. So without any further, let's get started.
So what we will cover in this tutorial: first thing, what you will need to mod your PlayStation, how to flash your Pi Pico, how to prepare your SD card, how to install the mod chip in your PlayStation, testing games and troubleshooting, pros and cons of this mod, and finally, my thoughts. Okay, first thing, what you will need, and of course the PlayStation, the 1000 or the 5500 model. And in this tutorial, I'll be using the 5500 model that I bought it from a flea market for $1, a Raspberry Pi Pico that cost me $2, and an incompatible SD card reader that cost me $2. You must use this exact model for better result. I use this model that I found it in my area in Garage LL until my AliExpress order arrived. A micro SD card to store your games, and finally some soldering skills and tools. So let's go to the first step, flashing the Pi Pico and adding games. Okay, first thing, download the firmware, that you will find his link in the description down below. Okay, now take the Pi Pico and hold the boot button while you plug it to the computer. The Pi Pico will appear as a mass storage device. Then unzip the firmware file and drag and drop it to the Pi Pico. It will automatically eject and unplug it from your computer. Then take your SD card and plug it to the computer and format it to the XFAT. Now you can add your favorite games to the SD card. And when it's done, eject safely the SD card from your computer.
That's the software part done. Let's go to the hardware.
Now it's time to tear down the PlayStation. Now try to locate the 701 chip in the motherboard and carefully lift the pins showing in the reference diagram. This pin is tiny, work slowly and take your time. Then turn the motherboard and mount the Pi Pico in this area using the double-sided tape. Now it's time to solder in the modchip by following the diagram shown in the file that you downloaded. forget to solder in these two bridges. And remove the resistor showing in the guide. Then bring your SD card and solder it to the Pi Pico by following the diagram. Okay, in my case, I soldered the SCCK pin to the CLK pin. No worries, they are the same. And finally, double check each connection after the soldering. And when you reassemble the motherboard, choose the spot for the SD reader for the Z axis. Then arrange the cable neatly, secure everything, and when it's done, insert the SD card to the SD reader.
And that's it. Congratulations, you mod your original PlayStation. And once all connections are made, reassemble the PlayStation. Okay, in your first boot, you can face a troubleshooting. Like if your PlayStation doesn't display the PlayStation logo at the boot, try installing the disk drive without the motor nap, just the lens nap. This can resolve the problem. When I first tested, most games were perfectly, but some games didn't work, like the Final Fantasy IX, or got stuck at the loading screen like the Resident Evil 3 and the Dino Crisis. This is usually a region issue. And sorry, I didn't mention that we are in PAL region, and this troubleshooting is only in the PAL console. So how we can fix that?
Try to use the USA version of the game.
And for the NTSC console, it worked perfectly.
So what about multi-disc games, like the Final Fantasy? Just put all the disc's games in the same folder of the game. And when you're prompted to change the disc, just open and close the lid of the PlayStation and it'll that work.
And now it's time to test in some games and see how it works. Okay, I put a lot of games that I love. So, what are we gonna try? Dino Crisis, as you can see, we download the USA version to work in this PAL version. So, let's get started with this. It's not taking a long time, as you can see. Great. Ta-da! Let's work.
You have mail.
Voila, let's jump another game. Okay, let's try. I don't know. Silent Hill. I love this game. Oh, as you can see, it's too fast. They don't take a lot of time. Okay, let's jump to the other game. Teifu, why not?
Capcom presents. Let's go!
Okay, now let's we talk about the pros and cons. What I don't like, what I like. I'm gonna start with the cons. Okay, first thing, this mod is require time, passion, and good soldering skills. This is a hard mod. This is not a plug and play solution. You need to be careful, or you can bring someone who can do that for you. Second thing, it's a new update. So some games may have issues like we faced in this tutorial. So keep your eye on the website for future updates. Okay, now let's we talk about the pros and what I like about this mod. And of course, the first thing is it's super cheap. Only $5 against the 120 for an XStation. This is a game changer. Everyone now can do this. The second and the most important thing to me, now you can play a massive library of games in the original hardware of the PlayStation. What else? Okay, now let's we talk about my final thoughts about this mod. And I think you have already the answer. Honestly, for $5, this is a no-brainer. It's an amazing community-driven project that brings life back to the original PlayStation. We're waiting for this for a long time. Thanks a lot. So why not? Go ahead, go enjoy some retro games and keep the classics alive. Peace. See ya.